the actual step-by-step process that somebody goes through? Let's say, for instance, a client wants to buy a property or buy an investment property, and the contracts get drawn up. What happens next? How does it all work?
Yep. So what we do is we obviously want to get to know our client and understand more about their personal situation, what's the structure they're going to use to buy the property. So if need be, we'll speak to their associated professionals that they're seeking advice from, be it an accountant or financial advisor, so that we can set the platform to understand the basis upon which this client's making the purchase. And then we get our hands on the contract and we look at the contract from the point of view of thoroughly detecting what's in the title. Is the vendor the same as the person registered on the title? Make sure we're actually buying from the registered owner. So into the nitty-gritties of that. And then right through to things like explain to the client the need for accuracy in the particulars of sale, that the price depicts the actual price they're going to pay, that the deposit amount is an amount that they can actually pay rather than just signing off, you know, to pay that you expected or the standard 10%, but not actually having the 10% to pay. So we need to make sure that that's something they can meet and that the date by which it's due to be paid is something that they can meet. Then we look at, you know, things like, is the contract going to be subject to finance? We need to make sure that that part of the contract's filled out correctly so that we don't run foul of being in default. Then we look at the special conditions. So the contracts are made up of general conditions, which are the standard general conditions that are prescribed in the contract. And then you've got special conditions, which are the additional conditions that a vendor's representative, be it a licensed conveyancer or a lawyer, will introduce into the contract to give that special cover, if you like, for their particular vendor clients. So what we need to do is nut that out and give the client an understanding of what they are, and also where possible, look to have them amended where necessary or where instructed by our clients. And that clients need education to be able to understand and then tell us what they want and or take our advice. So we need them to be brought up to speed pretty quickly, and we need to explain that in a way that helps them to understand it and not talk in a legal language that they won't understand.